Hello, everybody. I'm Marina Ranghetti, a research fellow at the National Resource Council. My presentation is about the exploitation of hybrid approaches for the retrieval of maize crop traits using hyperspectral and multispectral data. Starting from the general framework, this work fits into the context of precision farming and sustainable agriculture, in which the protection of water, soil, and air is becoming always more relevant. In particular, the focus is set in reducing human pollution of these two natural resources by improving their management. From this perspective, the geoinformation has a key role. Basically, the geoinformation consists in the manipulation of data with a spatial reference in a computerized system. In the context of precision farming, they can contribute to assess crop status and patterns in time and space. The goal of this work is the estimation of maize status using global observation, hyperspectral and multispectral data, together with advanced statistical tools for the retrieval of biophysical variables. The vegetation traits investigated were the leaf area index and the canopy chlorophyll content. Li is the green leaf area per unit ground surface area, while the canopy chlorophyll content specifies the content of the chlorophyll in the canopy. Speaking about the general workflow follow, firstly, the study area and the data sets will be defined. The data sets are used for the training and the comparison of different machine learning regression algorithms. The model generated by these algorithms will be validated with independent data sets and will be used for the generation of biophysical variable maps. Lastly, the results of this study are compared with the results of the official ESA Sentinel-2 toolbox. In the next slide, I'm going to show the material and the methods used for this work. The study area is located at the north of Grosseto. In particular, the test sites consisting in two maize crop fields, at north Lerogaie, at south Ceccarelli. Lerogaie was also divided in different subzones. Each subzone and Ceccarelli field present different irrigation systems and different plowing and sowing dates. The field measurements were carried out in both fields during June and July 2018. In particular, vegetation measurement and sampling were performed in 33 elemental sampling units, composed of up to 4 plots, for a total of 87 plots. In this image, the 87 plots are shown. The purple points correspond to the field measurement during the first field campaign, while the orange points coincide with the second field campaign. Two different types of datasets were used, airborne and spaceborne dataset. For both, we have several images whose scene has been observed at different wavelengths, and therefore it carries information from different parts of the electromagnetic spectrum. Highbrand Dual is an airborne sensor with a total of 408 bands. The images were available in 2 dates near the period of the field campaign, the 7th and the 30th of July 2018. The ground sample distance is of 1 meter in the first image and 4.5 meter in the second image. All the images were atmospherically corrected. This dataset was a sample on Prisma and Sentinel-2 wavelengths. Prisma is an Italian spaceborne sensor of the Italian Space Agency. The second dataset corresponds to the images taken by the ESA spaceborne and multispectral sensor, commonly known as Sentinel-2. It has a total of 13 bands. The images closest to the field campaign were on the 8th and the 2nd of August 2018. The ground sample distance is of 10, 20, or 60 meters, depending on the band that is considered. In this study, we use Sentinel-2 Level 2A products, which are already auto-rectified and atmospherically corrected. At the end, 3 datasets were used. Highbrand Dual, or a sample on Prisma-like and Sentinel-2-like wavelengths, and the real Sentinel-2. As I said in the previous slide, the Highbrand Dual dataset was a sample on Prisma-like and Sentinel-2-like wavelengths. Some analysis and pre-processing were done on both datasets. In particular, for Prisma-like dataset, the blue bands were removed together with other bands selected from previous studies. This picture shows the selected band along the spectrum. As it is visible, the blue bands were removed together with the atmospheric water bands and the swim region. Highbrand Dual is thus composed by 155 bands. For Sentinel-2-like dataset, it was researched the assets used in literature. A total of 8 bands will be used, and their location on the spectrum is visible in this image. The same configuration was used also for the space-borne Sentinel-2 real dataset. The method used for this work will be presented in the next slides. Prisma-like and Sentinel-2-like datasets were used for the training of machine learning regression algorithms with an hybrid approach. Basically, the input data are used for the training of machine learning regression algorithms. These algorithms generated the best model for describing the relation linking quantitative output variables to input data. The models are then applied for the generation of maps. Input data of the hybrid methods come from a radiative transfer model. A noise is added to these reflectances since they are coming from a simulation. Prosaic Pro is the radiative transfer model used for performing the vegetation reflectance simulation. It is a physically based method and it is originating from the combination of Prospect Pro and Foresail. Prospect Pro simulates transmittance and reflectance at the leaf level, starting from some structural and biophysical parameter. The output of the Prospect Pro is passed to the Foresail together with other required variables, such as plant structural parameters, viewing angle, and soil background. The result of this process is the simulation of the canopy reflectance. Prosaic Pro is used for the generation of a lookup table, in other words, the input data for the hybrid approach. Some preliminary analysis were performed for choosing the best size of the loops. In particular, starting from the biophysical variable ranges and viewing geometry from the Grosseto field campaign visible in this table, they were used as input for the Prosaic Pro RTM and the generation of lookup tables from 1,000 to 9,000 samples. These loops were used for training different machine learning regression algorithms in cross-validation. The accuracies and processing time of these algorithms were evaluated. This allowed us to compare the lookup tables with their different dimension as shown in this graph. On the x-axis, there is the loop dimension, and on the y-axis, the coefficient of determination or the processing time.
Marina, you have 3 minutes.
The continuous line represents the trained machine learning regression algorithms, while the dashed line are the timing. As it is visible, if we focus on GPR algorithms, the blue line on the graph, processing time grows together with the loop size. While the accuracy increases from loop 1000 to 2000, then it's becoming steadier. Based on this result, a loop of 2000 samples was chosen as a compromise between accuracy and processing time. The training phase was performed with different algorithms. 5 machine learning regression algorithms were chosen, and they are listed here. The tests with these 5 algorithms were performed on each biophysical variables. The result obtained with the proposed method by using Sentinel-2 real dataset were compared with the result of the official ESA Sentinel-2 toolbox. Sentinel-2 toolbox provides estimation of the canopy chlorophyll content and light from Sentinel-2 level 2A products. For each biophysical variable, the result of the best algorithm are reported. Light results are shown in this slide for Prisma-like and Sentinel-2-like datasets. In the tables, the cross-validation statistics are visible, in which Prisma-like dataset shows slightly better result. The best model was generated by 2 different algorithms, GPR for Prisma-like and neural network for Sentinel-2-like. This graph shows the validation of the estimated light against the measured one. Both datasets show comparable results and statistics. Regarding the MAPS product, Ceccarelli in the first stage has higher light estimated value respect to Lerogaie. Ceccarelli was shown before Lerogaie. For two reasons, it has a more advanced phenological phase. In the second date, Wolfi presents similar values. In the previous slide, we saw how Sentinel-2 results are comparable to the epispectral. Therefore, the model previously identified as the best was used for the real Sentinel-2 data. The result were compared with the estimation provided by Sentinel-2 toolbox. The validation of our model by Sentinel-2 real data led to good performance and accuracy, while bad performances are observable from the validation of Sentinel-2 toolbox. This difference is shown also in the maps. Canopy chlorophyll content results from hybrid approach are shown in this slide for the airborne dataset. In the table, there are the cross-validation statistics. Prisma-like dataset shows slightly better results. The MAPS model was generated by GPR for both datasets. This graph shows the validation of the estimated chlorophyll against the measured one. Both datasets show comparable result statistics, and a slightly overestimation is performed by the model generated with Prisma dataset. Regarding the MAPS product, Ceccarelli in the first date has higher chlorophyll estimated value respect to the Lerogaille. In the second date, they present similar values. Also for the canopy chlorophyll content, the model previously identified as the best was used with the RIA Sentinel-2 data. The result will be compared with the estimation provided by the Sentinel-2 toolbox. The validation of our model applied with Sentinel-2 real data led to good performance in error accuracies, while a number estimation is performed by the Sentinel-2 toolbox. This difference is shown also in the map in which Sentinel-2 toolbox saturates the chlorophyll values in Ceccarelli field in the first date and in both fields on the second date. Conclusion. With this study, we proved the capability of an hybrid model to retrieve canopy biophysical variables. The proposed method showed good results for both light and canopy chlorophyll content. In particular, the analysis performed on hyperspectral and multispectral datasets led to comparable results. GPR and neural network resulted as the most suitable algorithms. From the proposed method applied to Sentinel-2 real data, better results were observed respect to the ESA Sentinel-2 toolbox. Thank you.